Lucas Oil Late Model Dirt Series veteran Mike Marlar will no longer be racing with Ronnie Delk. We have a press release here from MSR Mafia over on Facebook. It reads, Mike Marlar and Ronnie Delk successful tenure draws to a close. Both Marlar and Delk optimistically look to the future. A partnership spanning 10 seasons quietly drew to a close this past weekend during the 43rd annual Dirt Track World Championship at Eldora Speedway. Mike Marlar made his final laps aboard the Ronnie Delk-owned 157. While the dynamic duo's run together has come to an end, it's not a soft ending. Delk said, my first weekend with Ronnie was in late October 2013 at Smoky Mountain Speedway. The first night we broke an engine and I thought we might be finished before we even got started. But that wasn't Ronnie's style. He came to my shop the next morning with an engine in the back of his truck. We put it in and we won $10,000 that night. Then it was off to the races, Marlar recalls with his signature smile. So it's actually Marlar saying that. Ronnie and I have accomplished a lot in the past decade, and he's been the absolute best friend and car owner a person could ever ask for. Together, Delk and Marlar have collected numerous wins across the United States, as well as the World of Outlaws Championship, and were a constant fixture at the nation's highest profile events. For Delk, it's been exciting to see what the team has accomplished. He said, my partnership with Mikey has been a great thing. I've enjoyed it, and we've built something we can both be really proud of. We have achieved a lot of cool things together in racing, and now we want to expand that partnership to other things. He goes on and says, my relationship with Ronnie, this is what Marlar is saying, my relationship with Ronnie goes way beyond the traditional one of a driver and owner. We're great friends. He's my greatest ally, and he's enriched my life. In the past 10 seasons, I have never pulled on the track without knowing that I had the best equipment available and that Ronnie fully believed in me. He built a premier team from the ground up, and I can never thank him enough for the opportunity of being his driver. It's been an extraordinary partnership, and I am excited for the next chapter of our journey together. Marlar added, my wife, Stacy, always says this, it takes a village, and she is 100% right. I want to say a huge thank you to Ronnie's wife, Carla, and his kids for being invested in helping us chase our dreams. Our success as a team would also have never been possible without the unwavering support of my ride or dies, Josh Davis and Jerry Sprouse. Delk and Marlar are grateful for everyone that has had a hand in their success over the past decade. Marlar then said, I'll be announcing my new racing plans here in the next week or so, but in the meantime, I'm looking forward to crewing for Ronnie's son, Jared, in his third Crown Vic race this weekend. And then you have the list of sponsors here. Marlar has not actually given any information on what he plans to do in the future yet, but he did post this. He says, the end of an era, and man, was it a good one. And Marlar had a pretty successful season this 2023 season. Over here on My Race Pass, you can see he participated in 74 events. He won 11 of them. He had 33 top fives, nearly half, and 46 top tens, over half. So he was definitely one of the top competitors in that Ronnie Delk number 157. And it's definitely going to be different not seeing him in that blue and yellow 157. He was one of the top contenders every single time he was out on the track. He was a threat to win. And he even led a number of laps at the Dirt Track World Championship at Eldora before his car eventually broke, like so many others did that night. But I leave it to you. What do you make of Mikey Marlar no longer racing in that Ronnie Delk number 157 Super Late Model?